Welcome to my channel, All for Health with Jane. Family, we are still on the Senzo Meyiwa murder trial. On this clip that we are going to watch and listen, Advocate Nxumalo is still taking Lieutenant Colonel Mangena through his cross-examination. Advocate Nxumalo wants clarity on the exhibit. This is a bullet exhibit that is filed twice and filed differently. The same exhibit, meaning the same bullet, is described differently. On one, it is described as being a possibility of a bullet of a 9mm, whereas on the other one, the same bullet exhibit is described as being undetermined. So there is no consistency here. When Advocate Nxumalo wants to know why there is no consistency in this description of this bullet, Judge Ratha is the one who is explaining. Judge Ratha explains the reason of that inconsistency as Lieutenant Colonel Mangena tries to give the answer to Advocate Nxumalo. Ratha explains the reason of that consistency to Advocate Nxumalo. When Judge Ratha says Lieutenant Colonel Mangena did well by using the word possibility, because otherwise this cross-examination was going to take another week. Family, you know, you can see how bored Advocate Nxumalo becomes. And he says it is within our rights to ask these questions. That's Nxumalo. And Nxumalo is a peaceful guy. You know, Nxumalo, normally, he's just calm. But for him to answer Judge Ratha in this manner, you can see that, you know, he is pissed. It's just that it is at a workplace. So he has to try and, you know, control and behave. Otherwise, he was going to say more than this. Family, let's watch and listen.
Lieutenant Colonel. There's one aspect that I wish to converse from you. I'm going to refer you to exhibit X13C of the record.
I have it, madam.
At 3.2 of exhibit X13C of the record, at paragraph 3.2, you stated that one of the exhibits that you received on the 14th of July 2020 was one fired bullet fragment, possible of a 9mm caliber, marked 217267/14, capital letter A1. Do you confirm that?
That's correct, madam.
Athi kule qiniso ukuthi kukhona inhlamvu eyadutshulwa kwaphuma ucezu olwaluphuma ku-9mm eyama kwangokuthi 217/14A1.
On exhibit X13B of the record, do you have that exhibit, Lieutenant Colonel?
I have it, Malo.
Thank you. At paragraph 3, the exact paragraph is paragraph 3.3.1. One of the exhibits that you received on the 13th of November 2014 was one spent bullet fragment of undetermined caliber and marked it 217267/14 14, capital letter A1.
Kuthiwa kukhona ucezu lwenhlamvu olungabonakali ukuthi kwakungabe kuyiphi ikhalibha kodwa olwamakwa njengo-217267/14A1.
So the question that I want to pose to you that the exhibit which I referred you at exhibit X13 C and the one that I'm referring to you now at exhibit X13 B, is it one and the same exhibit?
X13 D and X13 C, the Kaliba Kumbisa and Umbuzo Lanuti, in the Yoto.
That's correct, Mark. It's the same exhibit.
At Yabo, in the Yoto.
At exhibit X13B, you said it was the caliber was possible of a 9mm. And then at exhibit X13B, you say it's undetermined.
Lapha ku 13D uthi akwazeki ukuthi i-caliber leyo nhlamvu yini kodwa ngapha ku 13C ukuyichazela ukuthi 9mm.
Is that consistent?
Ukhuluma into engakhuqukuqi yini?
That's correct, my lord. When I opened the bag, when I first see it, I noted it immediately. So when I opened it, I couldn't determine the caliber or I couldn't say what caliber is it. So during examination, when I continued the examination, I could say that it's most likely or possibly of a 9mm caliber.
But you understand that we keep our example, we was going to go to ikhalibhe engakanani kodwa ke uma ngiqhubeka ngiyihlola ngagcina ngikwazile ukubona ukuthi cha ngingenzeka ukuthi ikhalibha le ewu-9mm.
Is it correct that you said possible, you are not certain?
Kuyiqiniso yini ukuthi kungenzeka, hhayi ukuthi nesiqiniseko salokho?
Malo, due to its damage, I cannot say that it's a 9mm, I said it's possibly 9mm.
Ngokulimala kwayo ke ngeke ngikwazi ukuthi ngilethe isiqiniseko ngithi u-9mm. Engingakwenza nje ukufinyelela ekutheni ngithi kungenzeka ukuthi ibe u-9mm.
Would that be correct then to put it to you, Lieutenant Colonel, that your conclusion regarding the caliber of this exhibit was inconclusive? You could not determine, since you indicated that it's possible
that
a 9mm.
Yeah, he says because it's damaged. And I think we also, is that the one which was at 90 degrees?
That's correct,
man. Hit the floor.
That's correct, man.
And it's talking like a scientist, that's my understanding. I would have said even that one was a 9mm because the other one, which was on the cupboard, was a 9mm. But in scientific jargon, as Mr. Nisi has said, science is a precise exercise. Then he says, when he looks at it, it's possible a 9mm. Because if he has said it's a 9mm, we're still going to spend another week.
We're still going to spend another week?
Yes, because we'll have to ask him, why does he say so? What makes him to say so?
It's within our boundaries to ask.
Hello?
It is within our...
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I say that's how he puts
it. Yes. No, it's fine.
You're undetermined.
You know, family, Judge Rata is a typical African old man. You know, African old people, men and women, grannies and grandfathers, you know, they don't stop talking. Whenever, it's like they know everything, you know, so they don't stop talking. So until maybe we take him as he is, we are not going to have peace. So anyway, family, thank you very much for watching this video to the end. Please do not forget to like this video before you leave. subscribe for my channel if you haven't done so yet. I love you, family. Thank you. Bye.